looking for the right way. He plays aggressively. 82. He goes for his shots. He's never ducked a shot the whole tournament. He's just trusted his game. And he's been good enough.
83.
Well played, Luca Brasil.
Well played indeed. And did it in style.
91.
And Mark Selby, I'm certain, will admit that over the four sessions, he deserves this. Four times champion, smile up at the balcony, saying, what can I do? Maybe a sign he will ride with him, but then when he was given a chance with his hand on the table, we saw then that he's plenty of heart. And just this pink,
98.
To add the icing on the cake. Championship. He's excited. Where's the cue ball going? Perfect on the yellow, that's where.
11-12.
Well, it doesn't matter about the yellow. He's made his time. Round of applause for Mark Selby. And this crowd going absolutely mad. Standing ovation. What a performance all the way through. And as I said after his semi-final, future snooker is in safe hands with the likes of Luca Brasil, who is the Kazoo World Snooker Champion 2023. Well played!
Champion, you threw everything at Luca, not just today but yesterday as well. My goodness, it is fantastic to see you back, Mark Selby. You gave it everything, Mark, but how tough did he make it, and how much admiration for his achievement do you have?
Yeah, you know, I mean, firstly, congratulations to Luca. You know, he's a great, great talent, great lad. Obviously, lovely family. Wish him all the best and enjoy the year. You deserve it, mate. You play fantastic.
Mark, ladies and gentlemen, this man here has given us a moment in sporting history that none of us will ever forget. That maximum last night, and I wonder what kind of consolation that was for you, Mark.
Yeah, you know, obviously it's great to make a 147 at the Crucible. Something obviously I was wanting to do. Never thought I'd do it in a final, you know. That's an amazing achievement. The atmosphere last night when I made it was something I'll remember for the rest of my life. But, you know, it's not about me today. It's about Luke. You played fantastic over the 2 days, you know. I mean, every time he got a chance, he looked like he was going to win the frame in one visit. And, yeah, you know, I kept breaking off, leaving him the shot to nothing. And apart from when I got back to 16-15, I think that's probably the first time he missed it. But, yeah, like I say, every time we potted a ball, I fancied him to clear the frame up in one visit. It was tough, you know, but I battled and gave it everything. Got back to 16-15, had a smelly black where I was pushing into the red. If I pot that, I felt comfortable at that time. And who knows, if I get back to 16, then it could be a different scoreline. But, you know, every credit to Luca, he deserves it.
Yes. And Mark, this has been a tough time for you and the family over the last few months, but what an absolute joy to see you playing with a smile on your face again. How special is it to be back in this arena where you belong?
Oh, amazing. You know, like I say, 12 months ago, it was just nice to come back and just play and just try and enjoy it. But from where I've been to where I am now, yeah, you know, I've enjoyed the last 2 weeks. Yeah, it didn't finish how I wanted it to, but, you know, with things going on off the table as well, not just with me, but with Vicky as well, you know, obviously it realises that health's more important. So at the end of the day, it's a game, but a game that you want to win, but if you don't, it's not the end of the world.
Well said. Chester, you are back. Thank you so much, Mark. Well done. Luca Brissell, you have waited your whole life for someone to say to you, you are the world champion. How does that sound?
I can't see anymore. I don't know why.
I think there are a few tears in those eyes. How tough did he make it for you?
Yeah, so tough. He's the worst opponent to have in the final, I think. he just keeps coming back, and he's such a fighter. And when it was 16-15, I didn't fancy winning at all, to be honest. I was missing balls by a mile, and I don't know how I did it. I made a good break in the last frame. Once it got to 17, I fancied if I got a chance to clear up, which I did, and great feeling.
You know, you came here as a 17-year-old. You're just a young man. Boy to man, we've seen you at this championship. It's taken you 11 years to get over the first round hurdle. I think you're getting the hang of it now. But what took you so long, and what changed this time, Luca?
Nothing changed. You know, snooker is a difficult sport, and in the first round, I could have lost to Ricky Walden. I beat him 10-9. So if I would have lost that game, then everyone would be saying, oh, he's lost again, first round. And now I'm the winner, so that's the small margins in snooker. It's crazy, and I still can't believe it.
You do things with class and with swagger and with real verve. We've loved the Luca snooker that you've been playing, haven't we, ladies and gentlemen? We sure have. But in terms... Team Brissell around you, how much have they given you, not just here, but all of these years that you've been the next big thing in snooker?
Yeah, unbelievable. I really have the best team, best friends, best parents, best girlfriend in the world, which makes me strong on the table. That was my friend. Yeah, and it makes you so strong, you know. If you don't have that team, then it's very difficult to play your best game. And yeah, it's fantastic. And I just want to say to Mark and Vicky, I just want to say stay strong, because I've heard some news, and I don't know if I should say it, but just want to say stay strong, Vicky.
The Selby family is the strongest family I know. Very well said. And it's a mark of the respect that you have for Mark and for his family. And I think the respect that we all hold you in, that you've been able to say that. But I have to say, you do things your way, Luca. You've partied in the build-up to this championship and right through it. So is it back to the practice table tomorrow?
Definitely. No, I won't practice, obviously, for a couple of weeks and months. I'm just going to enjoy this. And it's been a crazy week, as you say. No practice, just partying. It shouldn't be legal.
Well, it's a formula that's brought you success. Quick word for what might be happening back in Belgium and all over continental Europe. This is a huge moment for sport in your country.
Yeah, it's going to explode. And I was so nervous because I just wanted it to happen for Belgium and for Europe. And now it has happened. So I can't wait to see what it brings to the world. And I'm just so happy. I don't know how I did it, but I'm so happy.
Luca Brissell, you are a joy, and you are our champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your presentation party, Paul Whitehead, Chief Executive Officer of Cazoo, and Barry Hearn, President of the World Snooker Tour. Receiving a cheque for £200,000 and the silver medal. What a fortnight and what an effort by Mark Selby. And the winner, receiving a cheque for £500,000, the trophy and the title, 2023 Cazoo World Snooker Champion, for Belgium, for his family, Luca Brissell.
from boy to man. Tonight he comes of age, surrounded by his family, his girlfriend and his mum Marilla, his dad Carlo. Only the fourth non-UK player ever to win here at the Crucible. It's a first Triple Crown major title for this man. And Stephen John, how many more playing like that?
Well, it's been a breath of fresh air, that's absolutely sure, through this championship. He's made the final what it was. I think the quarterfinals said it for me. When he beat Mark Williams here, I thought, you've got a chance of winning this, because he played so well in that, and he carried on, obviously, and gone right through and won it, and played brilliantly. But it's the way he plays. It's a refreshing thing to watch. He goes for his shots. He doesn't care if he misses, but he pots more than he's entitled to.
And he's stuck with that game plan. He's had so much self-assurance and belief in his own style of play, and that's what's carried him through here, Steve.
Yeah, and delighted for his family as well. His father, we've all known for many years, has been sort of long-suffering over the years with his son playing perhaps a type of snooker that was too open, and everybody saying he should change. They resisted the temptation to sort of do what people told them to do. They stuck to their guns, stayed in Belgium. So I'm delighted for them all. It's great to see somebody play swashbuckling snooker, but with balance as well, and push the game to perhaps even more new limits than we even thought possible.
We were talking about Mark's character this evening, but how much did he show? Mm. I mean, to get over the line there, he said himself, where did he find that from? Well, that's what champions do. I thought he was brilliant, but he got his chance. Mark missed those couple of pots, and he took the frame, and then in the last frame to finish like he did with the century, sign of a champion.
Indeed, he was world number 10 coming in here. He's vaulted up the world rankings now to number 2. He'll start the season as world number 2. And interestingly, I was talking to Sean Murphy earlier on. He said, I'm just going to go for everything now. Do you think it's going to change?
So don't change there,
then. But do you think this more attacking brand of snooker is something that we've seen succeed so well with Luca? Is it going to change the way others attack the game from here on in?
It should do. Young players will be looking at that and going, that's the way to play, that's the way to win, that's the new game to play. Don't hang around, don't study up on every shot. See the shot, go for it, trust your first instincts. And this is the first player who's, I think, well, there's a few others, but he's the first player who's absolutely led from the front relentlessly. So it could actually make a difference change-wise. We've seen Cesar and Weir do very similar. Mm. Maybe it's the old style is slightly, ever so slightly changing.
Indeed. And I think it was significant that it was Luca that seemed to bring out the best in Mark Selby as well. We know that Mark is a granite player, but he's a hugely entertaining player when he opens up the way he did. Yeah. And who'll ever forget that 147?
No, he's had an unbelievable week. He's played great. He's had some titanic matches to get where he's got to. Put a lot of effort in to get there. You know, and you never ever give up on him, because you always think he's going to come back. But he was beaten by the better player in the final, it has to be said. It's the best I've ever seen Luca Brasel play. And it's funny, the shot selection we go on about and the way he plays the game, the one thing you need with it is an inordinate amount of talent, and he's got every bit of that.
He has, and he mentioned it himself, the impact and the profile of this sport in Europe now, in continental Europe, because that is a really huge market potentially, as we've seen, not just in Germany, but in Belgium, and in Holland, and the Netherlands, all over the place. There's so many budding players going to break through.
Yes, let's hope that does wonders for sort of Belgian snooker, and obviously I think anybody knowing it, it's possible. But do you know what's amazing? How many people have stayed in the room to watch? The respect he's got in this room is amazing.
Well, he's been totally entertaining. The people who've bought the tickets, honestly, they're hard-earned money. They got every bit of, you know, value from it over the last two or three days, because that final was, as I say, the first couple of sessions in it, and tonight, some of the best I've seen. It was just wonderful entertainment.
Well, he's shown the way on the table. Do you think he's going to show the way off the table? Will he practice before major Triple Crown events ever again, do you reckon?
Well, I'll tell you what, there's people now everywhere saying, I'm off to the pub, darling, I've had 17 minutes practice. I'm going to play darts, and that's my preparation for the next championship.
It's not a formula I think will work for everyone, but he's just been so refreshing in the way he's done it his way.
Yeah, to come back in the semi-final was incredible. To withstand Mark Selby was amazing. He is a total breath of fresh air. Where can he win it again? Where does he go from here? Mm. Does he play even better next season?
What do you think?
I don't know, but I don't want pictures of the party, that's for sure. If he's partying before he's won the World Champions, I don't know what he's going to look like when it's finished.
Well, gentlemen, I can only thank you and the rest of our amazing team, and I can thank you at home for being with us for the most unbelievable 17 days. It's been fantastic. Sum it up in one word, if you can, John.
Oh, just mesmerising.
For you?
Astonishing.
I think joyous. I think one of the most joyous, exciting championships we have ever had. And I think it's fair to say that La Vida Luca might be the way forward after this. From us all here in Sheffield, what a great 17 days it's been. And thank you for being with us to share in all of it. Bye-bye for now.
What's the matter? I'm a little bit